Hi guys, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. The new updated version of the SensorSweep, which is used to clean your sensor on your DSLR and your mirrorless cameras, is out. It's January, it's 2018, so I'm calling this the 2018 SensorSweep. So let's see what that's about. Let's do it. Let's clean a sensor together so you can see what's gotten updated with the best way to clean your sensor, in my opinion. First thing you need is you need a camera. Camera's got to have a sensor in it. You can use the mirrorless or you can use the DSLRs. The DSLRs, of course, have a mirror, so you need to know how to lock your mirror up. That's number one. You also need to know how to take a picture of a blue sky or a white sheet of paper, and it needs to come out white, not 18% gray. In other words, it can't look grayish. Then you take a picture and you can examine that picture in your computer and you can see if your sensor is dirty or not. Don't clean your sensor if it's not dirty. This is not a sport where we clean the sensor once a month religiously. No, you clean your sensor when it's dirty. It's kind of like your eyes. If your eyes are working fine, don't touch them, just leave them alone. So you need to be able to take that picture. Now, once you've determined that your sensor is dirty, you can do a simple clean out by taking your lens off and blowing out the chamber once you've got your mirror up, and that might solve your problem. But if it doesn't, you need a good cleaning of the sensor. And I didn't like sending my camera in, having to pay the shipping charges, having to pay the insurance, and then having to pay to get the sensor cleaned. And then many times it would come back and it wasn't clean. I had to do it over again. Well, that got expensive, especially on the higher priced cameras, where I was kind of like cheating on the insurance, but if I actually lost the camera, it would have cost me a lot of money. So in the middle of the 2000s, 2005 area, I invented the SensorSweep, and it's been getting updated all along. So the update this year is we've added a cleaning agent that will help to clean it for the more stubborn things that need to be cleaned. So what are we going to do? The first thing you're going to do, you're going to take that picture and see if the sensor needs to be cleaned at all. And if it does, you're going to have a fully charged battery. It's got to be fully charged. Then you turn the camera on, and after it's on, you go into your menu. And when you're in your menu, you're going to go and navigate your way to where the sensor cleaning selection is. And when you click OK, if you've got a DSLR with a mirror, listen, I'm going to push the button. You're going to hear the mirror go up. Listen. Did you hear it pop up? So now if I take the lens off, I'm going to be able to see straight down into the sensor. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to clean it just with the blower. I'm going to use gravity. Blow in there. I'm not going to put the tip inside because if I put the tip inside the hole, there's a tendency where I might touch the tip to the sensor, and you don't want that to happen. So you've got the ability to aim this at different angles. Your mirror is already up, so blow it out and let the dust fall out naturally. That might have cleaned your sensor right there, but I'm assuming it hasn't, and you need to clean the sensor. So the next thing you're going to do is you're going to prepare the SensorSweep, which comes with a couple of tubes. One of them has got some blue tape on it, which is a low-tack painter's tape. Very simple. You can get it yourself, but I give you some of that. And the other one is a tube with two ends. It's made with a low-static material and recycle material. And this is where we're going to put the cleaner on there. I'm going to take a cleaner tip out of the bag. The bag comes with cleaner tips. I'm going to pull one out. I'm going to be careful not to touch the face because I don't want to get body oils on here. I'm going to peel off. There's a white part. And that, when you peel that off, you're going to discard that. And that's going to reveal a sticky side. The sticky side is there so that you can attach it to the tube. And this tube is going to be used to get down into the camera. So I'm going to use a little bit of what's like a docking station technology. I'm going to put it between my index finger and my thumb, a little bit down. Then I'm going to look at it, and I'm going to dock this right on. So it's right smack in the middle. There's a round circle in the middle of it. You can kind of see that's the way it's been cut, and two edges that protrude out. And by using my two fingers, I seat it right on there perfectly. There's anything loose, you peel it off because you don't want anything down in your sensor chamber. Now, to make sure that it's on well, you're going to take the other tube, which is clean, and you're going to press. Not a lot. This is not designed to be something that's overdone, a gorilla in a china cabinet type thing. You're just going to put it on and it stays. It's not going to fall off and it's not going to damage anything. Now, the next step is we need to put something on here that's a lubricant and a cleaner, and it needs to also not dissolve the adhesive. So you can't just put any cleaning fluid on here because it probably will dissolve the adhesive that's designed to hold this all together. And when you dissolve adhesive, it becomes gooey and sticky. You don't want to put that in your sensor, so I warn you. But before that, we want to make sure that this is ultra clean, because this is where the damage can happen. A little grain of sand between your finger, if you rub it, you can feel it. It's very abrasive. If you get something like that on here, or have something on that on here, even on a microscopic level, it can actually scratch your sensor. So we need to do something to make sure right now, before we put this into the sensor and onto the sensor, that this is perfectly clean. That's where the other tube comes in, and I have this very low tack painter's tape, and I'm going to peel back maybe an inch or two, and I'm just going to lay it right across, not even going to cut it off of this tube at this point. And I'm going to just gently smooth it on, not put too much pressure, because I don't want to peel off the cleaning pad that's on the foam, that's the spongy stuff. I'm going to gently peel it back. And then anything that's on here is now on the tape. I'm going to carefully put this down face up. Now I'm going to get some alcohol. Now they got two kinds of alcohol, the kind that's 99% and rubbing alcohol that's 70%. I use the rubbing alcohol on purpose because the rubbing alcohol has filtered sterilized water in here, and the 70% of it is the cleaning part. So the wet part is going to lubricate the cleaning tip so that this way we can clean the sensor safely. Now, how am I going to get that alcohol on here? I need a very fine roller, something that will put on such a fine layer of this alcohol that you almost can't tell it's there. We got the perfect thing. They're called toothpicks, and you can get them in any store. Get the round ones. They got two kinds. They got plastic and wood. You can pick your choice. Some people like the plastic, some people like the wood. Now I take the clean toothpick and I put it in the alcohol for just about 4 or 5 seconds so that the toothpick can absorb it. Then I pull it out. I turn it straight up so anything that's like a big blob is going to run down, sometimes all the way to my fingertips. And then I'm going to just roll this, not rub it, not scrape it. I don't want any wood particles on here, right across. And I can smell that there's rubbing alcohol right on here. Now, what I do is I put it on twice. I put it in here, I dip it, put it straight up, I roll it across again, and now I've just got the right amount of humidity on here with the cleaning agent that is not going to bother my adhesive that this is built with. Now I'm going to take this, I'm going to put it right down into the camera, flat and even onto the sensor, and I'm going to go left and right, back and forth, kind of like I'm doing a very gentle polishing. You don't want to overdo it. You can actually turn it while it's in there because it's got a long side and a short side. And it also has four corners, so you use those corners to get into your corners of the sensor. So you clean left and right, up and down, you polish it off, okay, and then I do one long sweep from left to right and pull out. Then it's done. I'm going to put this down on the plastic baggie so I don't want to contaminate it, because I can use this a second time in this session. After this session is over, the black tip will be discarded, but the tube will go on forever. Now I'm going to do the blowing face down again. Any dust that was left in there is now blown off and is now falling out. And you're done. Now you can do the test by putting your lens back on. Turn the camera off so you'll drop the mirror and go back into a normal operating procedure. Now you can take a test of the piece of paper or the clean blue sky. and see if there's any more spots. If there's more spots, you can repeat the whole thing with the same cleaner tip only for this session. We don't want to take any risk that this cleaner tip will get damaged. Now, the alcohol is dried, so you can take that same piece of blue tape that you've got sticking out, and then you can lay this on, kind of like in an area maybe you didn't use. Put your finger on there, tap it, not too hard, gently, and then pull it very gently off. You don't want to destroy the sterile cleaning cloth that's on there. Now you're going to get, this is the part that I'm a little bit extravagant on. I get a clean toothpick. I don't want to risk contaminating this. I have a whole box of toothpicks here. They're the round ones. I don't buy the square ones. I dip it one time, then I put it in. I dip it a second time. I let it soak a little bit. I face it up so that there's not any one particular spot that's got more alcohol. And then I roll it across again. And that alcohol is on here. I lay it down. I close the bottle of alcohol because I have tipped them over. And then at this time, your camera should be open. You're going to go back down in there and you're going to clean it. Then you take another picture and your sensor should be clean because you have used a cleaning agent. You've lubricated the cleaning pad so that this way it's not dry on the sensor to cause any abrasion. You've done it all properly and your sensor should be clean. Now, what do you do with the tips after they're done? You can use them to clean the lens. You can use them to clean your glass. Use them to clean your LCD screens on your phone or the LCD screen on the camera. Just turn the camera around. Look how this shines. I don't think you can see it from there, but this shines like I put a coat of wax on here. This is just marvelous. Absolutely gorgeous. This 70% alcohol that we have been trained to go away from is the magic part, because it adds just a little bit of moisture that gives it that lubrication that it needs. And of course, the alcohol is there to do the cleaning part. So now I turn this over and I'm just gonna clean the LCD. And the LCD looks like it's brand new, like it just came out of the box. And now we have a clean sensor, a clean lens, and a clean LCD. The lens and the LCD is, compliments. Wasn't part of the cleaning session. So what do you do with the tips? You can take the tips and you can save them. And you can clean your eyeglasses or anything else, or you peel it off and toss it and start again. I peel off this tape that I have used so that this way I don't reuse a piece of the tape. And I just pat it down a little bit, not too hard. I want to be able to re-peel it. And then I put these away. And I'm ready to clean my sensor again the next time it gets dirty. So the 2018 SensorSweep is out. It's on. I'll put the link down below. It's on my website. And we're using our secret cleaning agent, which is 70% alcohol, not the 99%, because that will not put any water on there. And we do need to lubricate so that we're not dry rubbing the sensor. And that little bit of extra sterilized, pure filtered water that's in this alcohol, the 70% rubbing alcohol. Of course, use a clean bottle. Don't use a contaminated bottle. And you use clean toothpicks. Don't use any contaminated toothpicks. Buy a box and keep them just for sensor cleaning. And that's it. You've got the 2018 SensorSweep. One of the best ways that I have found to clean your sensor, keep it clean, and safely clean it. One of the worst things is to have anxiety when you go to clean your sensor because you're afraid you're going to ruin it. You're not going to ruin it because the cleaning tip is a quarter of an inch of a spongy foam material, so nothing hard ever hits the sensor. When that tube comes down and touches the, I'm going to mount this again, it's going to have a soft cushion. You know, you can practice on an ND filter or a polarizing filter until you can get it clean. They've got a nano coating on it similar to your sensor. And when you can make this shine, you are an expert and you can do it now on your sensor. Remember, you want to use the tape right before you go in, okay, because you want to make sure there's nothing on there that's gritty or anything on there that can scratch. Then you want to lubricate it and you're going to use our secret sauce, 70% rubbing alcohol, and then you're going to clean your filters and you're going to clean anything you want. You're just not going to reuse the cleaning tips on your sensor for a second time. You can only use it in one session Once you're done, these things have to be discarded, or you use them for something that is not such a critical nature, like the sensor of the camera. That's it, Peter Gregg. We've done it. The link is down below where you can order them. I do ship them internationally. Thank you for watching. I appreciate it. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Bye-bye. Whoosh.